Number two, Allah obligated on us in a place no human being reached before. Prophet Hassan lived in Mecca. The zakah, the psalm, the hajj, all came while Prophet was in Mecca or in Medina. When it came to the salah, situation is different. Allah gave the salah to the Prophet in a place no one heeded it before. والرسول صلى الله عليه وسلم وصل إلى ما بعد السماء السابعة. والرسول صلى الله عليه وسلم heeded beyond then the seventh sky. Now we talk about James Webb. I'll say he reached in there and he discovered it. So what's the situation? Someone was asking me, is it possible they can discover the Arsh? They can reach the Arsh. So I want to see what we know and what is the reality. Allah said in the Quran, الَّذِي خَلَقَ سَبْعَ سَمَاوَاتٍ Allah created seven skies. Dibaqan means one over on top of, above the other. Seven. So that seven was our situation with it. Allah said, Ya ma'ashara al-jinni wal-ins, assembly of the jinn and the mankind. In istata'atum, if you are able, antam fudu, to pass beyond them, min aqdari samawat al-ard, beyond them the level of the skies and the earth. Kum fudu, go and pass beyond it. But Allah said, La tanfudun. You will never be able to pass and go beyond them, the skies and the earth, illa bi sultani, without permission. So did Allah give permission to this kuffar to go through some of the sky and go up? الحديث متفق عليه عن مالك بن سعسعة رضي الله عنهما أن رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم قال رسول was talking about الإسراء والمعراج. الإسراء from Mecca to Qudus, Jerusalem. And the إسراء from Jerusalem up. So when journey of the Mi'raj starting, Prophet said, فَانْتَلَقَ بِي جِبْرِيلُ Jibreel took me up حتى أتى السماء الدنيا until he reaches the end of the lowest sky. The end of the lowest sky. So the sky finished and the second one starts. So what's in there? Something we didn't see, but of telling us. فَاسْتَفْتَحَ